Yeah, so Nabani kind of, it's a map that really kind of worries me, because that first point can be so difficult to actually take, but not only if you're finally able to capture it, going into the final moments of the map is very hard to finish off because of the really long distance it takes from the respawn back into like the final push, mm-hmm. and there's so many different angles you can be attacked from that you have to really take high ground control. Then you have to think about maybe flanking the areas you're seeing on your screen, maybe go around that left-hand side and hit their supports. It's very difficult to attack, but a team that's flexible like LG Evil has every opportunity to make it work. I think more the pressure goes on to Toronto Esports to see what LG Evil are running and try to be able to outplay them, you know, kind of make it their own. And they're initially going to be on the attack here, Jameson.
Yeah, and the thing is with, I guess, like the multi-tool that Jake is, he's got a lot of heroes in his back pocket. So once they get onto the offensive end, I mean, it's going to be very difficult to try and read for Toronto Esports. Are they going to try to go for that 2-2-2 dive? Are they going to go for a pharmacy? We don't know. It's going to be very hard to try and scout out. But on the defense so far coming out, LG Evil, they're already hovering over that 2-2-2. Jake going onto that Soldier 76, which we've seen him do more and more of.
Yeah, Soldier. I mean, Soldier is perfect on Nabani just for the fact that you can play from the high ground, you can play from distance, mm-hmm. and you're forcing the enemy team to commit to jump onto you. You're very fast. You can obviously run away. If you have a Vassar to protect you, then it's very hard to finish him off. Or if you have what they're currently doing, is keep your entire team off of him or onto him. It means if you're going to dive in, you're diving in with three, but hey, we got six there to stop you. So just a simple numbers game, you're going to be overpowered.
Yeah, here's the thing. A lot of teams used to stay spread out, right, on that initial defense because teams were playing a lot of Ana, but now with the prevalence of Zenyatta, they don't really have to worry about that. They can clump up and they can peel for their squishies. Now, they are pushing in Oni God with that Soldier 76. He's slowly making his way up onto the high ground. There's no one there quite to contest him, but they do have that mobility on the side of LG Evil to do so.
I don't think they're gonna contest him though, because there's gonna be so much pressure coming in for Toronto on the forefront. You can see Jake immediately drops down to the backhand side as Jaro was just trying to deal with them, and he just can't pick up that 1v1 kill. And now Toronto have to back away, but they're just backing away into their own deaths. There's three quick kills coming through.
Yeah, I liked LG Evil's approach to that. When the dive came out onto them, Jake just immediately booked it out of there. He was already on the low ground, and that's one of the things that we saw, particularly, I believe it was like when Rogue was playing Nabani. When they make that jump up there as a coordinated unit, you have to just disengage, fall back, and just give up some ground and try to wait for the offense to actually just spread out a little bit too much.
The thing is, if you're the offense too, and you do dislodge them from that high ground position, then why not just hold it? You don't really need to chase, you know, you can just heal back up, you have them out position, you have them spread out as well, you know, split between the team, so you have the opportunity to easily pick up those kills, get that man advantage. But here we go, jump comes in yet again, Jake immediately jumps back, and Jarwin trying to finish him off, but Jake just runs away yet again.
Yeah, Super was able to get that kill onto Snow, and once again, in that last engagement, it was Jaru and Snow that went down first too. So, this is very telling of how LG Evil is approaching this, right? Just take out those two and then win the team fight from there.
Yeah, so they're playing a dive comp, but a passive dive comp, and actually a dive comp that runs away instead of running into the team. So they're letting Toronto get the engagements they want, but they're just outplaying them at that rate. So I would like to see maybe Toronto, I don't know. I mean, they kind of have to keep going the same strategy, right? If they take opposing high ground, it just comes down to whose soldier is going to be better and maybe what Genji could get in the right position. But yeah, if they attack them yet again at the high ground, they're just going to run to the same, you know, pitfall.
Yeah, we're also seeing like the difference in impact so far. LG Evil, they've got three ultimates up. Toronto Esports, they're pretty far away from Oni God's tactical advisor. Jaru does have that blade at the ready, but Rob 420, he's getting closer and closer to a transcendence.
If Jaru is going to go in for Jake, he's going to need the speed out of his Lucid, out of Luda, to keep him alive. And we're going to see the initial kills come through. Jake did pop his tac visors to make sure they have a solid victory on this fight, which they will very much do. Avast picks himself up a double kill, and Rob will close out onto Note. So, what, they invested two ultimates?
That was so disciplined.
Yeah, and the visor, that's it.
And like at Primal Rage, you know, it's not the most impactful. It's really useful when you're trying to stall out, right? So for Super to use it, it's not that consequential. And now, with 1 minute and 20 seconds, Toronto Esports, they're really baking up a lot of these ultimates. Note, he's 4% away from his self-destruct, but it's Snow, who is so far away from his transcendence right now.
Luckily for Snow, though, there's nothing on the enemy team for LG Evil that is gonna force him to use his trance. It's more just keep his team alive as they go for that engagement. Which, speaking of that, we do see Ani got pop his visor, but look, there's a D.Va, it's Bull, directly in his face. He's completely shut him down, not to mention he's gonna be chased down. Or I was being chased down for a second before he does get away.
Note did get a pretty crucial kill onto Vol, so now Oni God has no one to stop him. He's on the high ground here, just spotting them out, getting free damage off Helix Rocket did connect, but now they're playing line of sight, and Jake, it looks like they're just gonna force them back. Oni God goes down as Train gets the flank onto him. Now we're in the hot seat for Toronto Esports. 37 seconds left on the clock. They've got three ultimates to work with.
So you're banking on Jaro, you're banking on this Blade, right? Mm-hmm. Problem is Rob, he's got his trance. He's already ready to go to stop this. He's in a perfect spot to stop, to prevent this from really working. Jake's gonna be able to run away, and he has the healing, or he doesn't need to run away, obviously, with the Transcendence. But Luda needs to stick with Jaro to give him that speed, to give him that mobility so he can actually pick up a kill, because they're all grouped up, which is a perfect position to use this Blade.
Yeah, but he hasn't gone in quite yet. Snow is gonna use that Transcendence first, but Jaro goes down without using his Blade. That was a boss that took him out. It's a 6v5 sound barrier coming out from the side of Toronto Esports, and with that, Cynic was able to pick up a kill onto Jake, but now both of these supports getting caught out. It's gonna be Snow that goes down, but Super with the backhand. Did he get the kill? He will actually be able to get the cleave kill onto Oni God and LG Evil. Only giving up one tick, about 62% so far, as Jaro comes back. He's got the Dragon Blade, but the self-destruct comes out from Vol, and Super will finish off Jaro.
Avast booped him back so he could not run away from the self-destruct to pick up that kill. That was insane. But I mean, Jaro, okay, so we'll talk about him really quickly, and I swear we don't mean anything negative by this, but yes, he died with his Blade up, right? But he knew that there would be a trance to stop him. Mm-hmm. So he was trying to bait out the trance so then he could use his Blade to actually pick up kills. If he used his Blade, it would have been countered out by the Transcendence and he would have gotten nothing from it. So I like the move. It's unfortunate he died without getting the trance popped, but that's kind of a showing of LG Evil and, you know, in particular, Rob, of just realizing, well, I don't need to use his trance just yet. I don't have that pressure on me. So very smart play by them. And you already pointed it out, just smart use of ultimates in general. Really good ult management out of LG Evil.
Yeah, you can see the real discipline coming out from LG Evil Squad so far. So now it's going to be LG. They're on the offensive. And take a look at that win condition, 62.9%. That's all Toronto Esports was able to get. Yeah. So one victory, and it could just all be over here on the first map.
Not to mention, if you're defending here, Jamerson, like, you it's so difficult to have proper ult management when you know you have to hold that first point. And you have to hold it below 60 or 63%. So you're gonna be more likely to commit an ultimate that you don't need to mm-hmm. make sure you don't lose the point, right? To make sure you don't lose that extra person or to make sure you get those extra kills or two.
Yeah, so no one wants to save an ultimate until exactly. The next map. So.
Yeah, it doesn't work like that, right? No. So, I mean, people might hope so, but it doesn't work like that. So you're gonna have to be a little bit quicker to use ultimates, which is always gonna work in LG Evil's favor, but at the same time, you know, LG Evil, were forced to defend first. So they were the ones that actually kind of set the standard, set the win condition for themselves.
All right, so Toronto Esports, we got about 20 seconds before LG Evil get out the gates here. They're sticking with that exact same composition. Cynic on the Winston, Note on the D.Va, Oni God on the 76, and Jaro once again on, the Genji.
Well, look where he's playing, right? Oni God was just dancing over a spray. Mm-hmm. Look how far back they are. They're actually not on the high ground. So they're not trying to contest the high ground position right off the bat. So Oni God's assuming he's gonna be pushed down and he just might as well just back away anyways?
They've gotta be careful though. If they do that, LG Evil might just be able to get onto the point and just get a tick for free and then set that goal even closer here as they are approaching from the high ground.
They're on the point already. They're actually getting very far in progress. They're actually almost up to a third here. Finally, someone's able to jump on the point, but I think they did accomplish that. Jake on the high ground is gonna be able to just spam away at them, but they're all on the low ground to contest. They're out of line of sight of their own healer. Cynic is gonna fall because he doesn't have the healing there around the corner of the point. It's still halfway now done here, Jamerson. A misplay. Position for Toronto Esports is just going to cost them this first map.
Yeah, it's just Luddy there along with Oni God, and he's going to get cleaned up very shortly. And that's exactly what we were talking about. You pointed it out. They were far back in Main Street there. They were over by the car, not trying to contest the high ground. And that allowed three members of LG Evil just to hop on, get a free tick. By the time anyone noticed, it was already too late.
And Cynic was forced to jump back, right? And then he jumps into the point. He has to play in a really bad position where he can be hit from every angle to be in line of sight of his healers, and they don't have an Ana to out-heal the damage being done to him. So the defensive position was a little bit awkward of Toronto, but maybe they were hoping for that first initial fight victory to transition that into more, but that wasn't even close.
Yeah, with that initial offense, I was expecting Toronto Esports to go something a little bit cheesy, right? Try to go for that Torbjorn, something that teams might not be ready for.
I hate
at least.
You so much right now. Yeah, go for something. Go for the Torbjorn. He's like probably my most hated hero behind Mei.
Yeah.
And Genji. Yeah. And Hanzo. And D.Va.
Boy, I almost just went on a rant. A comp Q rant. But I'm not going to right now. I am going to talk about Toronto. It's really hard to judge them too much based on their defense because it was so short there. Maybe not the best plan coming in as far as defenses. But you could tell they had a plan.
Let's not judge them. Let's just talk about LG Evil and how well they played on the defense, right?
Well, maybe I want to judge them a little bit. You know?
I mean, we are American, right?
Yeah, no. Wow.
Are we? Are we all American?
I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know anymore.
Sorry, am I
No, but what I was going to say, what no, I was going to say
definitely
is,
American.
I actually liked a lot of the things that they did on offense. Obviously, they didn't work out very well, but you could tell they came out with a game plan. They wanted to get at Jake, first of all, mm-hmm. which has worked with mixed success in the past. Really, whether or not that was a good choice is beside the point right now. They weren't able to get to Jake, so it was more of an execution issue. I also thought their ult management was all right. I mean, they popped three ultimates.